Okay, hallo YouTube. Das ist Etherfields Intromission, Swift Rules and Boost Chills. Have fun with the game. I describe how this game works and the rules are. And I show you the intro of the game. The intro you play is every game the same. But after you play the intro, you can choose different paths. That's the best thing of this game. So I spoil anything. You can later decide or write me if you want to see more of this game. Write in comments down below if you want. Okay, so let's start. I will explain more of this game. So we are starting at this blue dot here. I'm playing the Reaper right now. And this is the setup of the first intro mission here. So you see this clock right there. So guys, you know what we can do. We can manipulate even the time in this game. So if we are start with one player, we get 5 hours. And what we can do with these hours is we can spend hours in two ways. One, to move. This action is described on the basic action card. This card here. So we can move with hours. Or one, to add extra turn cards. So if you're running out of turns, so you can spend your hours to manipulate your turn deck. This is one great tip for me, pro tip, before the game starts. So even more tips. So here's everything you need for your first game. I've set it aside. Blocked roadway, some eater, and some of this damage tokens. Let's see how they called in this game. They are called distress markers, yes, and you can take 8 of these for your charm. And if you take, you take 7, and if you take your 8, something bad happens. Then you must reveal the card, and the card tells you what happens. We don't know it yet. We just don't reveal it yet. Because it's the start of the game, so. Hey, cards, and when do I get this? This twist markers is, you get this markers when you must reshuffle your deck. So if you're playing your char, and you have no cards left on the left side here, you get a first distress marker. So, quite easy. Here's your charm marker. So, the game says we start here and we don't know where we are. And how we landed here. The only thing the game tells us is we will get 4 cards. This is what's happening now. I will get myself the first 4 cards. For my first turn. And I have so many possibilities. Shining. Hurry, hurry. And hurry, hurry. So what can I do with this card? So, as I told you before, you see this yellow here? Yes, this one. Okay, you can move with yellow. So I can move my char around with my cards I have on my hand. And so I can play these 4 cards. And after I've displayed 4 cards, so turn ends. And we got a new turn card. And then we... depends on how many cards we have left back on my hand. I get number of cards back, 2 additional to my hand, and this is what we can do. I have no special card here, so no progress card. And I can seal these cards here directly if I would like to do it, to restore items. So, but I don't have any items here right now, so the first thing I will do is I'm starting here on my field and it says, hurry, hurry, something wicked this way is coming. And then I have my so many possibilities cards. And this is the first card I will use. Because here's the green sign. And I use the green resource for my card from so many possibilities. This one here is green. So I use it to gain one blue. One of the shiny gems here. And this is called Shining Gems. Shining Gems are represented in rules. Okay. I can use them to re-roll a die, I think. Or I can use them, sometimes you can use them on cards. So, okay, what cards can I do? I can only do one thing on one card. And then yes, you said use one shining game to reroll one die. Okay. So, okay, what do I do next? I have many movements left and two red, so maybe I will go to the assault. So I spent my shining card for another movement. And I will go this way here. So now the round ends, and I will just discard the first round card. And here's the new one. And you see, every round has a different loop. So if you attack someone and win this combat, you gain different loot each time. And I think this game is growing bigger and bigger, so this game will get bigger and bigger over time. This is what I'm thinking about. So let's see what happens next. So we have drawn a new current card, okay. So let's see what's going on next.
Next phase is we get back our cards to our hand. So it's turn our dreamer's phase, draw step. And draw step means each dreamer with two or fewer cards in your hand draws four new influence cards. And each dreamer with three or more cards in the hand draws four cards up to the hand size limit. So, I have two, so I draw four new. Three and four. And here are my new cards. I got effort, I got tough, talkful moment, and hesitation two times. So this goes maybe wrong. I decided, so I need six assault, but I only have just want to assault, but now I get complete another card. I only have four and three green. So what else can I do? I can try to open the door for free.
this cost me enough? But I need three. Yes, this is one thing I can do. Check the yellow altar. So this is what I can do. So I can use two yellow to move and three yellow. So I can use this one. So I'll do use two to move. One, two, to here. And now I'm here, and this is my first thing I can do, check the yellow altar. And I pay now exact three. I must pay three. And this is what I will do now, three yellow. So I pay three yellow, yes. And then I can lay down this nice little header here, and I can lay down this red one. This one says I can do only this one thing one time. This is what is said here. And if I have more than one player, I must give them six yellow. But I'm only one player, so I'm lucky. So let's next read page 159 and see you next in my next part of this intro mission. If Ada Fields with Bruce Shields, subscribe for more, have fun with it.